Welcome to the 2023 installment of 32 and 32 season previews. I'm Dan Rosen, along with Amelie Benjamin, and we're going to touch on everything from off-season moves and playoff outlook to fantasy prep with Anna Dua a little later. Today, we're taking a look at everything New York Islanders. Amelie, they were a playoff team last year. They got in, they lost in the first round, but I think there's a lot of confusion, or maybe not confusion, just wonder about where this team is going right now. Because yes, they were a playoff team and they lose in the first round. And frankly, I don't know that they're any better than they were a year ago when they won 42 games and barely got in.
It feels sort of like they're treading water. They're probably not going to be that different, and they're still going to have a great goaltender. So the storyline is pretty much the same as last season. So my question is, should this team have made bigger moves going into this season?
That's been a big question for a lot of people, wondering what's going on. Like, why are they not making those moves? Like, they were 22nd in the league in scoring last year, 2.95 goals per game. I thought you in the league now, you pretty much have to score three a game to get in. They're right there. So they were able to sneak in. But I don't know that that helps. I don't know that they're any better. I mean, the one addition that they made that's, you know, you can look at and say, all right, maybe that's a player who can play for them is Julien Gauthier, who's at best a depth player for them. The loss is Josh Bailey, who had turned into a depth player for them. And they traded him to Chicago. Chicago didn't want him. They bought him out. He's a free agent, right? So nothing major here. You're talking about a team that is coming back with a lot of the same guys. Yes, Sorokin is great. They may have the best goaltending tandem in the National Hockey League with Sorokin and Semyon Varlamov. And they've got a lot of players there, but are they, that, are we going to keep going? Like, are they any better? Matthew Barzal, okay, you get a full season out of Bo Horvat, right? I like their D. Pulak is there. Ryan Pulak, Adam Pellick, Noah Dobson, Alexander Romanov, solid top four D. To me, it's just underwhelming because of what they didn't do this offseason. Like, I would have loved to see them go out and get Alex DeBrincat from Ottawa, but instead Detroit got him. The Islanders couldn't do it.
It's sort of just a blah situation. I think that's what you're looking at. It's a little blah. And, you know, I am intrigued to see, you know, what you're going to get full season of Horvat, as you mentioned, Matthew Barzal. You know, they have talent, but there's nothing exciting that pulls it all together. Right. And that, I think, is what they're missing and what they maybe missed out on in terms of opportunity this summer to change that.
The one thing I will say, though, about the Islanders, and this is what you need, they're built well down the middle, right? And that's why they are going to be a contender again, to get it to be a playoff team. Matthew Barzal, who missed a lot of time last season, he's there. He is a dynamic player. There's no question about it. Brock Nelson, he can score goals. J.G. Pageau, Casey Cizikas, they're built well down the middle. I mentioned their D. A key guy we'll see some more growth from, maybe from the back end, Noah Dobson.
Absolutely.
And Alexander Romanov. Those two guys.
Yeah, there are places for this team to go. There are jumps that can be made. But there aren't prospects that you're seeing are going to hugely break out. Mm-hmm. You know, you might see some improvement from those guys in the back end, from Dobson, but there's no exciting talent that's coming down the pipeline here to save them.
No, there isn't. But what they have, and we've mentioned it, is an elite goalie in Ilya Sorokin. And we'll bring in Anna now from a fantasy perspective. We've touched on the questions we have with the Islanders and their offense, not even scoring three a game last year. But they have Sorokin, right?
They do. And Sorokin has something that is so rare among the netminders in this league, and that's consistency. So across his first three seasons in the NHL, he's had, at worst, a .918 save percentage, .924 last year, a Vezina finalist. This guy is the most consistent goalie in the entire league, and I personally think that he is the best fantasy goalie option heading into the season.
And the value of fantasy goalies, I mean, when you get a guy like Sorokin, yes, Varlamov can play too, we know that, but you know Sorokin's going to be the guy, right? I mean, that makes him even more valuable.
Yep, and despite the team around him, I think that's really critical because we see these goalies who sometimes they get a little bit inflated because they're on these stacked teams with great offenses, great defenses. But Sorokin, regardless of the team around him, regardless of the injuries, he always puts up phenomenal numbers.
Is he good enough to get the Islanders in the playoffs? Again, we're doing playoff predictions. Anna, you start.
It's tough because another player I want to highlight before I say my prediction is Oliver Wahlstrom. I'm looking to see what he does this year, especially with their depth down the middle. And we haven't seen much of his full potential in the NHL, obviously limited last season. So maybe he can spice things up a little bit. But even if he does, I don't have the Islanders making the playoffs this year, guys.
All right. Amelie?
Same. I think the problem for the Islanders is they saw another team in the Metro get better in the Pittsburgh Penguins. Yeah. So I think maybe you see the Penguins come and take that spot that the Islanders took last year that the Penguins missed out on. So I'm leaning no, even as good as I know Sorokin's going
right.
to be.
I agree with you on the Penguins thing. I also, again, you have to look at the other division too, right? Sabres are getting better, and they should be pushing up. Ottawa's another one of those teams. And the Islanders are a team that's, they kind of just feel stuck in neutral with great goaltending. I don't think it's going to be enough. So like you two, I do not have the Islanders in the playoffs right now. Thanks for joining us. And a reminder that NHL.com is providing in-depth roster, prospect, and fantasy analysis for each of the league's 32 teams every day through September 1st. And of course, you can find us right here on NHL.com and NHL YouTube as we continue to break it all down. See you next time on 32 and 32.